sin, Lord. We give him all the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Hallelujah. It's you have won. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. We give you praise. We give you glory. Thank you for another beautiful day. Thank you for the gift of resurrection. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. It's my honor and privilege to welcome you to service today. Thank you, choir. I would have loved to keep the choir singing for some time, but we're pressed for time and we have to fit in everything within the time that we have. So I'm happy to welcome you to church. We give God praise for another Easter Sunday. Wow. What a mighty God we serve. Easter is extremely remarkable in our lives as Christians. We celebrate the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus, the foundation of our faith. Without the death of Jesus, our faith has no meaning. As much as I love Christmas, one of my best seasons of the year, if Jesus was born and he didn't die, our faith will have no foundation. But we give God praise because death could not hold him captive. The grave is empty. It's a beautiful resurrection day, and we give God praise. And I'm happy you're alive to see another Easter, one of the year 2024. We give God praise and glory for his mercies and his grace. So welcome to church. Today we're going to have a bit of spice into our usual service flow. One of my friends will be joining me here to talk about Easter shortly. And we're going to bring you a lot within the short time that we have, and your life will never remain the same. My prayer is that as we mark this year's Easter, whatever that is there in your life that's supposed to be alive will rise to a new life in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. So once again, you're welcome to church. So at this point, I want to introduce one of our guests, or set of guests that we have, we're going to be listening to us today to mark this year's Easter. Please join me as we make welcome the Royal Diadem Choir. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We give God praise for that beautiful rendition by the Royal Diadem Choir. Wow. We give God praise for this year's Easter Sunday. So once again, welcome to church. Lord bless you. I hope you're having a good time so far. We're going to delve right into the word. We have a limited time, but I hope that by the grace of God, in this short time that we have, you're going to take something away as we look at Easter. Our theme for today's service is the tomb is empty. The grave is empty. Taken from Luke 24 verse 3. Luke 24 verse 3 says, then they went in and did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. Amen. I've been joined by one of my friends. You would have seen him in previous services. I don't know whether to call him apostle or to call him pastor or to call him reverend. But we thank God for his life and what God is doing through him and his ministry. Let's welcome Pastor David Roth. Great, great, great. We have a very short time, but within the limited time we have, let's see what God will have us here today. The tomb is empty. The grave is empty. Easter is super significant for our lives as Christians. So what do you make of our topic for today? The tomb is empty. Hallelujah.
The tomb is empty. Jesus came for his assignment was in these days. Number one was his birth, which was the arrival of hope to the world, the hope for redemption. The second stage of his assignment was the crucifixion. He was crucified, which signifies death, which also signifies the death of flesh, the death of the old. And then the third stage of his assignment was his resurrection, which signifies the birth of the new, that which was stolen from the people of God, the child of God, the creation of God, has been restored back. More like the Bible said that he went into hell while in the grave to take the key, to take the power, that which Adam gave away. So the significance and the relevance of the tomb being empty means total recovery. It means restoration. It means redemption. And most importantly, it means victory. Amen.
Amen. Praise Amen. God. So Hallelujah. As Christians, we've got redemption. Yes, we've sir. Got restoration.
Yes, sir.
We've got total victory.
Yes, sir.
Wow. You see, like I said earlier, I love Christmas.
Yes,
and
sir.
It's a beautiful time. I like the weather and all that. But you know, and you try to chronicle the what you call the three pillars of Christ's assignment, his birth, his death and the resurrection, right?
Yes,
as beautiful as his birth was and is, but without his death, our faith has no foundation,
exactly,
right? The things that you mentioned, redemption, restoration, victory, have no basis. So Easter is quite significant for us as Christians. It holds a lot. In fact, it is the center of our faith, if you may put it that way.
That's right.
Because his death opened a new vista of life for us as Christians. You know, and there are lots of scriptures to look into around this. But before we get into that, I'm going to ask, how the weaves, I mean, like you mentioned, you talked about the significance of Easter for mankind and for us, right? The question is, how do we begin to walk in the realities of these things, right? Talk about redemption. So first you have to come to Jesus, receive him. Talk about restoration. Talk about total victory. So the question is, how do we begin to work in the light of the fact that this work is finished? I don't know if you understand. It is finished. So, but it doesn't look like it's finished when we look at our lives.
Yes, sir.
So how do we begin to walk in the reality of the finished work of grace?
Praise God.
Yeah.
I will first use this example before I use a scripture. Sometimes last week I had an encounter and I saw this giant. You know, like he came to break, to squeeze, to harm me, some sort of. And I was asking him a question in the realm of the spirit. I said, what have I got to do with you? Why do you bother me? and he was still going to go on to do what his father, the devil, sent him. And I told him, you can do nothing to me because I have been justified by the blood of Jesus. I am justified by the blood. And the guy disappeared. So the death of Christ, the resurrection of Jesus, justifies us from every form of condemnation. Romans 8 said, for there's therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Okay, now how do we begin to walk in this light? The first step is what you just mentioned, sir. By the Bible say in John 3, it said, if any man be born again. Okay, so it means that there's need for a rebirth. There's need to believe in the name of Jesus and be redeemed by his blood. That's the first step. Now, the second step is faith in your heart, connecting to the word of God, you actively believing the words of God and walking in the word. You know, like I always say, there's already so many distractions on earth. There are so many forces pulling your attention here and there. But one way to walk in the light of this word is focus. Number two, determination. It takes a determined soul. It takes a soul that is focused, that is hungry, you know, that despite the distraction, despite the forces pulling, trying to get my attention here and there, I am looking up to Jesus, the author and the finisher of my faith. He never promised us that it's going to be free of storms. He said, we are going to have so many troubles, so many afflictions, but out of them all, he will come through for us. So one way to walk through this is definitely putting your gaze on Jesus. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you. So you talked about focusing on Jesus.
Yes, sir.
First is the rebirth, which is the primary experience.
Yes, sir.
And then you focus on Jesus and determination. You know, we live in a very beautiful time, and
yes,
it's good you pointed out, you know, distraction and how that tries to take our attention away.
Yes,
but I want to read a few scriptures, right? You know, that I just put together because I was trying to get ready for this service.
Okay.
In 1 John 2, 2:2, the Bible says, and he himself is a propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but also for the whole world, which is the first point you made, which is,
yes, sir,
Christ was given as a sacrifice to take care of the wrath of God that could have come on us because of our sins. Let me put it that way.
Yes, sir.
Now Christ is the propitiation. Now Galatians 3:13 says, you know, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become curse for us. For it is written, curse is everyone who hangs on a tree. Now these are the things that the death of Jesus on the cross has delivered to us.
Mm.
Now another point is Ephesians 2:12-13. That at the time you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in this world. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who were once afar off have been brought near by the blood of Christ.
Mm.
Wow. Now let me throw in one more. Let me just throw in this one. It says, for you know the grace of our Lord Jesus, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that through his poverty you might become rich. So, I mean, we can go on and on and on from the scripture.
Yes,
what
sir.
The death of Jesus really means.
Yes, sir.
I want to speak to any of these scriptures. You know, first, we've been brought near. And two, you know, he's paid the price. He's taken care of the anger of God,
yes,
and he's now our propitiation for our sins.
Mm-hmm.
Cause everyone who hangs on the tree, he died a very shameful death of a criminal, death of those who are cursed.
Mm-hmm.
And so what has that got to do with us in terms of our lives today and what it means? And the Bible says we're far off, now we are drawn near.
Yes, sir.
So can you explain a little more how these things can become a reality in our lives, given that these are the things that the death of Jesus on the cross took care of?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, verse 2 of 1 John is the propitiation for our sins, and not for us only, but also for the sin of the whole world. Now, it sets the whole world because the world began with a man. And the man was Adam. Now, through this man, every other man came into existence. So that's why the Bible says, when one sinned, all had sinned. So redemption, destruction came through one man. Redemption has to come through one man. Adam sinned, everyone died in the spirit. Jesus died and resurrected, and everyone also resurrected out of failure.
I hear.
The Bible says he bore our shame, he took our affliction all upon him. He took our place in affliction. Mm. He took our place in shame. Mm. He took our place in death. Mm. So he died a death so that we can be made alive through him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So the position of Jesus as the crucified Christ is the position of judgment and condemnation. Though he took upon him what he did not commit. But like I said, he took our position so that he could die our death, and then we can have access to life. Mm. Now, the life we're talking about is the very life of God that was in man in the beginning, which he lost. We are being granted access through Christ to this life. Now, in this life, we don't fall sick. In this life, we are not ashamed nor reproach. Yes, we could suffer persecution. We can face temptation. But then we are also not being given temptations that are beyond our capacity. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So in this life, this new life that Christ is offering us, is giving it back to us, which is our originality, is glory, is victory. I'd like to read one or two scriptures. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Okay, 1 Corinthians 15:13. Say, if there's no resurrection of the dead, then not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, our preaching is useless. So is your faith. More than that, we are then found to be false witnesses about God, for we have testified about God that he raised Christ from the dead, but he did raise him if in fact the dead are not raised. Okay, if you study the scripture very well, you want to go into the historical background, you realize that there was some argument within, whether or not there was resurrection or no resurrection. Yeah. And Paul here is trying to put it straight that if there was no resurrection, if it has stopped at the cross and the barrier, we will not be here today. Mm-hmm. So the beauty of Christianity is in the resurrection power of Christ. Mm-hmm. Now, the resurrection was where God showcased himself, where the glory of God was showcase. At the resurrection, at the death, which was before crucifixion, Jesus was being beaten, he was being spied on, he was reproached, he was insulted, and then they took him to the cross. Heaven was still watching. It wasn't time for God to manifest himself, to glorify himself. When you are going through that pain, when they push you here and there, God is still watching. His gaze is on you. He's looking at what you will do if you will give up in the process while you are being tempted. If you will give up while you were being insulted. If you will give up while you are being beaten. God was watching. Don't forget that the Bible say, weeping may endure for a night. And shouldn't you also forget that Jesus rose in the morning? He said, very early in the morning, Mary went there to look for him. And she could not find him in the grave.
So I don't know who is listening to us today. Your morning is breaking. And that resurrection is here. And that reproach is coming to an end. And that affliction disappears right now. So while I was seated there and you know, the ministration was going on before I came up here, the Spirit of God began to deal with me that out of today's ministration, healing virtues will flow to touch the body of people, those who have terminal diseases, who have been suffering from one or two afflictions. As a result of the resurrection of Christ, that affliction leaves your body in the name of Jesus. Just to wrap up this, if the whole of heaven came into manifestation to glorify God in the resurrection of Christ, because in that resurrection of Christ lies God's capacity to restore whatever the devil messed up. Amen.
Amen. Wow. You know, I'm just afraid to, time is not always our friend. Wow, I don't know what to do. But we've got to begin to, you know, tie this together, right? Amen. What an amazing prophetic moment we just had, you know, a minute ago. Now, talked about sickness and you said something I want us to clarify. Is it that we don't fall sick, or that even before we fall sick, there's already a provision?
There's already a provision.
There's already a provision before we fall sick.
There's already a provision.
Somehow, yes, you may fall sick for some reason.
Yes.
But God has already made a provision in the death of Jesus. Yes. You know, where I want us to wrap this up, it's simple. You said heaven came to glorify the entire heaven. Came to glorify God through the death and resurrection of Jesus, right?
Yes,
and many of us, many people still think that eternal life is an event coming in the near future, right? Because you said he took our place that we might have his life.
Yes, sir.
So if I am born again, do I have the life of God now? Do I have eternal life? Or there's eternal life I'm going to have in the near future?
I think it's John chapter 5. First John 5, right? It says, whosoever is born of God
overcometh
the world. And this is the victory. You see, one of the problems we have is the simplicity of redemption, of the process of redemption. You feel that I've been a murderer, I have committed so many abortions, I have cheated on so many people, and then somebody just comes to tell me to confess and all is gone.
It looks simple, right? Suddenly I have the life of God inside me.
The simplicity of the process of redemption make people ridicule or take for granted the power and the potency of redemption. But as simple as the process is, oh my God. My God, that is all you need to be translated to having the life of God, to having that very victory Jesus came to deliver to us. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So once I take through that process, I have the life of God.
Yes, sir.
And I must begin to walk in the consciousness of the fact that I have, not I will have.
No.
I have the life of God.
Yes, sir.
And begin to explore the provisions that God has made in the life that is in God.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I'm sick, there's a provision for my healing.
Yes, sir.
Whatever that I need, because God, Bible says, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. So if I have the life of God, he's my Father, then the fullness that he has belongs to me.
Yes, sir.
Now, this is what I remember, the story of the prodigal son, who after having wasted the inheritance, when he came back, he was received full and restored fully, like he didn't do anything wrong. And a party was thrown, which was just justification, just like you didn't do anything wrong.
Anything.
And party was thrown for him, right? Yes, and it just mirrors the kind of relationship that we have with our Heavenly Father. So it means that can you come back when you find that you have lost your way? Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Our time, I'm being warned that our time is fast spent. Okay. We need to wrap up. I'm afraid this is where we're going to draw the curtain for today.
Okay.
But in a nutshell, I think at this point, it would be nice to give those who want to give their lives to Christ an opportunity.
Yes, sir.
Because it's a resurrection day.
Yes, sir.
To give an opportunity to say, Jesus is no more in the grave. Amen. The tomb is empty. The Amen. Life of God is available. Amen. If only you can confess. Amen. That process that looks simple took someone's life. Amen. But it's free for you because someone has paid for it. Amen. At this point, I want to just say a word of prayer. For those who want to give their lives to Christ, that the life of God will be impacted in their spirit. Go ahead and just say a word of prayer. Just lead people to Christ.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
If you're here and you have come to this point of decision of having your life being redefined to Christ Jesus, I like you to say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. I accept you this day as my personal Lord and Savior. Say, cancel my name from the book of death and write my name in the book of life. Say, I am born again. I'm a child of God. I have eternal life. Jesus' name, God bless you. You are welcome.
Amen.
You're welcome to the fellowship of the brethren.
Amen. Welcome Amen. To the family of God. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Rob, for coming.
Thank you for the privilege, sir.
Always a great time to have you. And hopefully we'll invite you again Amen. To delve a lot more into this. And you know, we'll have a lot more time to have a lot more discussion. Thank you, and God bless you for coming.
Thank you,
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's say a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for your word. Let your word bear fruit in our hearts. And let the power of resurrection be made manifest in our lives. In the name of Jesus. Amen. It's our offering time. Amen. We're going to have a special number from the choir as we give our offering. I hope you're ready with your offering. Our counties are going to be on the screen. And then we'll have a special number from the choir as you give your offering. God bless you.
The beginning, one with God the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, a Christ. What a beautiful name it is! What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is, nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us, so Jesus, you brought heaven down. Whoa. My sin was great, but your love was greater. Let's go.
The name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, for your name is powerful. Thank you for the death on the cross and the resurrection that brought us life. What a powerful name, the name of Jesus. Demons bow at the mention of your name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege to bring you an offering. Blessed be your name, O God. Receive it from my hands and let it be used for your glory. Bless us in return, in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Before we take our word confession, let's go to the media for announcement.
Good evening, great people of God. Happy Easter to you. We thank God for the last Sunday of the month of March. Welcome to this edition of the Fountain of Goodness broadcast. We will be right back. Thank you for staying with us. What a time to be alive in the land of the living. We had a great time in His presence today. It is our earnest prayer that the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwell in you and quicken your mortal bodies in Jesus' name. Amen. As you continue to join us every Sunday for a glorious time in God's presence, may you have a continuous testimony of new and great things in the name of Jesus. Amen. We are fully persuaded that God will make all things work together for your good in this season and beyond in the name of Jesus. Amen. Your God will surely come. He will come and save you. Isaiah 35 verse 4. If you desire to be a member of the church, please fill out our membership form posted online or send an email to us via info@fountainofgoodness.online or visit our website www.fountainofgoodness.online to complete the form. Also, if you desire to receive Jesus into your life or did so in any of our services, please fill out the form posted online by our workers and we will reach out to you with further details. You can also send an SMS to the church phone lines and we will be in touch with you. We want to be part of your journey and provide support where necessary. Should you have testimonies, please send in your testimonies to 0703-993-4862 or 0912-662-8731. We want to rejoice with you and thank God for what He's doing in your life. Kindly follow us on all our social media handles. Share and like our content. God bless you as you do so. Please watch out for the Word for the Week by our lead pastor, Brother Chinedum, on all our social media handles and his personal handles. We have come to the end of today's Fountain of Goodness broadcast. May you experience the resurrection power of God in all areas of your life in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Have a blessed week and a happy new month filled with beautiful experiences. Bye for now. Shalom.
Amen. Welcome back. Praise the Lord. You're going to declare with me and say, God is my light and my salvation. I will not be afraid. He has called me out of darkness into His marvelous light and made me a light to the world. Darkness has no place in my life and everything that concerns me. Wherever I show up, light shows up. Because I am the light of the world. The light of God reveals things to me. I have understanding of my times and seasons. His word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Therefore, I have the direction and I do not stumble on the path of destiny. All the days of my life, I will walk in the light of God, and the light of the knowledge of the glory of God is made manifest in my life. I take possession of my inheritance and walk in the light of his promises, not by my strength, but by the light of his countenance, because he favors me. The Lord is my light, and darkness has no place in my life. In 2024, the light of God shall be made manifest in and through my life. In the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Holy Spirit. And we all say a big amen. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. What a glorious time we've had today in God's presence. We're going to be closing out the service shortly with the Royal Diadem Choir. But I just want to thank you for being part of today's service. Our phone numbers are on the screen. Our email address, please send us a mail. Reach out to us. We want to rejoice with you at what God is doing in your life. Don't forget that tomorrow we'll be looking out for Word for the Week on my social media handles and that of the church. And the Lord shall bless you. Let's say a word of prayer. And then the Royal Diadem, we close out with a song. Father, we thank you. Thank you for being with us today. Thank you for the blessings of Easter. We decree that this week is blessed, and it shall be so. Let the benefits of Easter be made manifest in our lives and cause us to walk in the fullness of the power of resurrection even in this week. We give you praise and glory because we know that this week our businesses, our careers, the works of our hands are blessed beyond measure because Christ has paid the price for our upliftment and for our increase. Lord, we thank you for a glorious week ahead of us. Receive all the praise and glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Praise God. God bless you. Have a glorious week ahead. And let's sit down and relax as we close out with the Royal Diadem Choir. God bless you. And bye for now.